Oh wow, the sky is so nice.
I do like the colors though.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, wait. Hey, we're falling. Why are we falling?
Yeah. This is going to be inconvenient.
It will lie.
Everybody loves flying. It's cool, it's swift, and it's also very expensive. Because hydrazine is our only fuel for flight, there's an endless demand for quick and simple solutions to automate their creation. So today, I've come up with a design that gets the job done with minimal space, and I'll be covering a quick guide to adapting my design to fit your playstyle. To make hydrazine, you'll need ammonium and hydrogen. Thus, in order to have an efficient factory, you need to locate an ammonium vein and at the same time be on a planet where you can obtain hydrogen. Once those are checked, you need an odor extractor, an atmospheric condenser, a chemistry lab, and to make it compact, you'll need some extra large platforms and one odor arm to keep everything connected. To start, set up your odor extractor on a good point to maximize your gain. Place an odor arm near the output and establish your extra large platform at its other end. All you need to do now is put your modules onto the curved platform, set them to loop with the right output resources, and place a medium fluid canister to store your goodies. Once it's all done, connect it to a power source and your factory is ready. All you have to do now is mind your own business and return with an empty fluid canister to repeat the process. Although the previous design takes up very little space, there is not a lot of hydrazine you can really store with it. So, if you want more storage, you can always extend this design further. All you have to do is switch your curved platform into an extra large rectangular one, move your modules and your auto arm onto it, and slot in a large storage module that is filled with medium fluid canisters. With this, you can easily output as many hydrazine as your storage permits, giving you way more hydrazine than what you need. In the case that you want to build your hydrazine factory without immediate access to raw resources, feel free to split up the process with storage substitutes. With this, you can easily set up your factory near base with an even smaller footprint at the cost of making more trips in the process. And that's it. I hope you like my design, feel free to expand upon it, and please never build this in Atrox. If you have too much hydrazine to spare, you can always turn some of your hydrazine into diamonds to show off to your friends. That's going to do it for today. If you enjoy my content, feel free to like, subscribe, and ring the notification bell to see more videos from me. Check out my recent video about building the most compact dynamite factory, or if you're interested in Astroneer collectibles, I have a playlist for that too. Thank you for watching, my name is Sandbokne, you guys have been awesome, and I'll see you in the next one.